Hi, Errichto here with Dynamic Programming Lecture number 3. If you haven't seen the previous two episodes, links will be in the description below. Go watch them and then come back here. Enjoy the video. We're solving only one problem today, but it has multiple solutions and you should try to understand all of them. The problem is line of wines. There are n wines in a row. Each year you sell either the leftmost or the rightmost wine, and the ith wine has the initial price pi. But if you sell it on the kth year, the price will be k times pi, because older wine is more expensive. You should choose which wines to sell, each time leftmost or rightmost, in order to maximize the total money you will get from sales. We're given an array with prices. Here the leftmost wine would have price 2, then 4, and so on. This is the initial price, the one that could be used if we sold this wine in the first year, but then it grows. An optimal solution for this example would be to sell the leftmost wine in the first year. For this we get 1 times 2 money, which is 2. Then in second year sell the rightmost wine. In the second year sell one with initial price 5. This is 10. Plus in third year sell this one for 2. Plus in fourth year, so that one for 4 times the year, and 5 times 6 in the last year. This is 6, 16, and 30. We have 12, 18, plus that it's 34. In total, it's 64. You can also think about greedy approach, taking each time the more expensive or less expensive from leftmost and rightmost wine, but it wouldn't lead to an optimal solution, and this example shows it. You would get the total result of 63, which is not optimal. We start the process with the whole array of n wines, and after the first choice, the first sale, we are left with first n-1 wines, or the last n-1 wines without the first one. And the year is 2. We had year 1, after the first sale we are left with year 2 and the remaining n-1 wines. We would like to know then what is the best result for that remaining interval. This suggests the state should be start the first position, the leftmost remaining position L, R the rightmost, and year Y. It would be here L, R, and Y. Maybe dynamic programming with those three dimensions would work. It's important, if possible, to get rid of some dimensions of DP to improve the complexity. And here that unnecessary dimension is actually Y. Because if you know L and R, you can figure out what Y is. If you're left with this interval, you know that apparently you sold 2 wines on the left and 3 wines on the right. So since year 1, 5 more years passed, so the current year must be 6. This means we do not need state Y in the state, and the state of RDP will be just LR, the remaining interval. You can see the tree of recursion, the transitions between state on the left. And since there are some repeated states, here 2n-1 and again 2n-1, this means DP should be used and can be used. We said the state is DP of LR, and to compute it, you must consider two choices that you have when you have interval LR. Two possible choices are take the leftmost or the rightmost wine. If you take leftmost, you get y times a of, not a, p of l, this is the score you get, plus dp of l plus 1 r. The remaining interval is l plus 1 to r. We are interested in the maximum, max, of that, and the same thing from the right, y times p of r, plus dp of L R minus 1. That would be a correct transition. One quite tricky thing here is to figure out in what order we should go through the states. And that's something we'll talk about at the end of this lecture. Now we can just go to a different solution. This one was bottom up, but the name isn't very important. You should just understand how to come up with a solution, not really how to name it and whether it's bottom up, whether it's recursive or iterative. Just get some working solution. Solution 2. After we already made some decisions, we should think what is important so far. Obviously the score, the money we earned so far, and removed wines, or just the remaining interval. Again, the state will be LR, possibly we could store year Y, and we need that money. Then I will remember LR, year is unnecessary because we can figure it out from L and R, and score, the best score so far. That's what is important. Score, since we maximize that, this will be the value of DP, and the remaining things here will be the state, the dimension. And by score, I mean score so far, how much money we earned already. Then if we are here at DPLR, from that state, we know that we can go to state, let's say L2 R minus 1, and the score will be DP of LR already plus PR times Y. This is possible value that we should put here for interval LR minus 1. We'll say that DP of LR minus 1 minus 1 is equal max of that, comma, dp of L minus L and R minus 1 already computed. We just say that it's possible to go from this state A to this state B, and using the value of A, we update the value of B. This is example of push dp, where we use the current value to compute the next one, to update the next one. And remember, the definition of DP here is completely different from the first solution. In that solution, it was what is the best score we can get for this remaining interval. At the end, we just print DP of 0 and minus 1, or DP 1n if we count from 1. Here, it's a bit harder to figure out what is the answer we should print, because we define DP as the best score so far. So how much money we can get from those wines that are already sold. Then at the end, we need to write something like maximum over all DP of II, the intervals of size 1, or depending on your implementation, maybe just intervals of size 0, like DP of II minus 1. Or I would here print minimum, maximum, because we maximize, of DP of II plus n times p of I, because dp of II is the best score outside of I. If the remaining interval is I, how much money we could get from wines sold already, plus this is money we get from wine I itself. The last solution is quite unique for this problem. It turns out that we can compute the answer for every interval. In the first solution, for every interval, we computed the best value we can earn here if after some number of years we are left with this interval. But if we are left with some small interval, we know already that the year is not year one, it's some bigger year already. Here, what if we need to compute, or we want to compute, just the answer for every interval, meaning if we care only about those wines and we start at year one with those wines, what is the best score we can get? If we can do that dynamic programming, at the end we will just print the DP of the whole interval. If interval LR minus 1 already knows its answer, assuming that we start at year 1, in this case because the interval has size 3, it thinks that it should use multipliers 1, 2, and 3, two prices, year 1, 2, and 3. But what we want to consider is to compute the answer for interval LR, starting here at year 1, and then shifting those to 2, 3, 4. And it magically turns out that since we increased every multiplier by 1, the score will be increased just by the sum of those three values. And here, if we define dplr as the answer, if we have just this interval and we start here with year 1, at year 1, then we can say dp of lr is maximum over from interval lr minus 1, we take its interval, we add the sum of all the values there, plus we have this price with multiplier 1, which is just pr. We could simplify this to just the sum from L to R. And this can be computed first with prefix sums, then we don't even need a two-dimensional array for that. Then what I wrote here as three dots, by that I mean considering interval L plus 1 to R. You can ask why we can add the sum of values in interval L R minus 1 to dp in that interval, and we'll get an optimal score if we start at year 2 for that interval. No matter what is the optimal order for that interval, actually for just any order, let's say 1, 2, and 3, no matter if it's optimal or not, if we now say we start at year 2, then each number is increased by 1. So no matter what was the order, the score was increased by the sum. Each value got plus 1 to the multiplier. So each possible order got plus the same value to the score, so the optimal order is still the same, just in the score is increased by the sum of values. In my opinion, the most important part of solving dynamic programming problem is to correctly define what we are doing. Then we'll see how to initialize things and what to print at the end. We can compare, thinking about it, those three solutions. In the first one, dp of lr was the most we can earn from interval lr, obviously. We start with interval 1 and at year 1. So for interval lr, we can figure out what will be the year. And this is some formula. And dp of ii, those intervals of size 1, we can initialize easily. We know that we are at year n when we get to that last line. And the money we earn for that is just pi times n. That will be price at year n. In the second solution, dp of lr was the most we can earn so far when we get to interval lr from lines that are outside this interval. We start with dp 1n equal to 0. And at the end, it's harder to say what is the answer. The answer will be the maximum over those values. And dp of ii was best score outside of I. If we sell already n minus 1 wines, everything except for wine I. And we must add pi times n to that. In the last solution, solution number 3, what we have is dp of lr is the most we can earn from interval lr starting from year 1 here. That would allow us also to answer queries. If we only consider this interval and forget about other lines, what is the answer? And you just read that from dp array. We assume that no other lines exist. Then we initialize dp of ii as just pi times 1, because we say we are at interval 1 here. And we use that sum of things in the interval to compute every next dp of lr. With iterative DP, you must be careful about the order of states. The code you see right now on the screen is incorrect. If you want to compute DP LR in this order, starting from small l and going to big L, then the issue is to compute, for example, DP of 110, you here need already computed DP of 210. But that's not yet computed. You will only later go to bigger L. After considering L equal to 1, only then you will go to L equal to 2. That's why a correct order here would be to go with L from N to 1 downwards. We can see here whether to compute dp of LR, we can indeed use those two values. L decreases, so when we get to L, for sure we already computed, considered all values for L bigger by 1. And for the same L, for one fixed L, we go with R in increasing order. So indeed, if we are at LR, we already considered LR minus 1. And by considered, I mean we already computed the score for that interval. And this is pseudocode for the first solution, where also we use that year, where year should be that formula, something like N minus L plus R, whatever it was on the previous slide. If dp as state uses an interval, then you could also just figure out whether your solution should compute small intervals first and then long ones, or the other way around, and then first of all iterate over the length of interval from 1 to n or from n to 1, then iterate over possible start of interval of that length from 1 to n minus length plus 1, I think, and from that you get r. So those two loops aren't necessarily over L and R. There can be, for example, over length and then over L, but still, you can compute R, so you can use dp LR as state and an two-dimensional array with beginning and end of the interval. I hope you understood all three solutions and differences between them. If not, try watching the video again, or just ask me in the comments and I will try my best to help you. See you in the next dynamic programming lecture. Bye bye!